Hey, welcome back, my friends. This is Angel Malus here, and this is another episode of Ticket Legends, right? Okay, so I'm not gonna go crazy on this. I wanted to continue this stuff. We gotta go with GenderStream. So we are not done with that yet. We have more projects to do, but GenderStream, we're gonna go ahead and play with some BE stuff. And this thing seems to be still okay. I mean, if it needs some Gelorium, it does have EMC, so I can just like slap some more. And we'll be fine for now. I'm definitely gonna go build a better place for that, but for now, we're gonna go ahead and play with the bees. Now, I have been working on the base a little bit more, and I made a hole right here. So, if you can see, I made a hole in here, and it just goes down and 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 down, and voila. So, I like this spot. I don't know how it... I just found it, and look at this. It has a ravine on this side, and on this side, it has like a little path. There was a cave system over here, and it hits another ravine. The ravine that is on the other side under my base. So I kind of like this spot. So I fill it up with block of quartz, a couple of redstone lamps for lighting, and I make sure that there's no mob spawning around this area. So we will be working out our path out here. So let's see. We did crafted a couple of stuff since even last episode, I believe. So here's a couple of the machines or the blocks that we will be using. First of all, we need to have a mutagen producer. And this guy would make... everything requires EU. They require power, RF I mean. And you put something in here. In this case, redstone blocks actually. And it would create mutagen, which is a type of liquid. So mutagen producer, I think we can go ahead and grab two of those guys, because we will need a good production of it. So yeah, there we go. This thing has EMC. A lot of them don't have EMC. So the ones that do have EMC, I'm just gonna go ahead and grab them and place them in there. So with this, we are gonna have to use it for the advanced mutagen. Now this thing produces mutagen. And advanced mutatron requires over here that mutagen, you see right there. So it requires some power, some mutagen, and then you can decide of which combination with genetics labware, what kind of queen you want to have. So basically it's like a mutation at will. So you put one queen here, one drone here, and you can select which mutation you want to definitely have. So obviously it costs energy and it costs mutagen. And this is what that is for. So once you make that with this, I'm gonna be able to breed to get the exact breed that I want. So as long as I know which are the parents or which are the parents, then I can know which one output we will be getting. So for that, we're gonna make a list of that. Then once we get a lot of them, the next stop would be getting the genetic sampler. So we need to get some genes out of them. So this one would take a bee, and you put the blank template here, some genetics labware here, and it will give you one of the genes here. So GenderStream. There we go. So one of these genes. So you see it gives you species genes and species flowering fertility. What is it? There's like a lot of things. Lifespan, what flowers that it uses, the effect that it produces. It has a lot of things that it will throw out. You see, put something in there, and this only requires energy, so it doesn't require much. But I think we may need a couple of them because they're pretty slow, or I'll just automatically put them out. And next thing, we have the genetic replicator, the genetic transposer, genetic imprinter, and protein liquefier. So protein liquefier and DNA extractor. We're gonna need these guys over here. So this one gets me some protein. So it depends on what you put here, some food and whatever, it gives you some protein. But this is pretty much for the end stuff. And DNA extractor. So this one, you put a bee or a tree, of course, and it will give you some liquid DNA. So you need those two things, so protein and liquid DNA. And this one, the generic replicator, you put energy, of course, you put some liquid DNA and protein, and you can create with a complete template one of the bees or butterflies or even trees. So after getting all these genetic samples, you can create a package, and with aid of these two things, you can put that package in here and get your result of whatever you like. Now there's two things left here, the genetic transposer and the genetic imprinter. So this imprinter, basically, you get those DNA samples, you put them in a package, you put the package here, you get some labware with energy, you just put a bee here, and whatever bee here you put in here is gonna imprint those DNA qualities into that bee. So let's say I get maybe species of white willow, and I make it in a package, like this one's the genetic templates, and I put this here. So it doesn't matter what kind of bee I put it here, as soon as it gets touched with this, it will become the species of that, or the height, or the fertility, and stuff like that. And we will definitely need that, because some of the bees that we're gonna be working with, they don't have more fertility than one, so they will never be able to reproduce in large scales, especially like the ender ones. All right, the genetic transposer is the next one. So basically you put either a gene sample, or you put basically a whole package, a whole genetic template. You put it here, you put it one here, and then you put an empty one here. So the one that you have with something, you put it here, and the empty one you here, obviously with some genetic labware. And basically it will just create a copy, because once you put the gene sample into a package, it will disappear and you cannot get it back. So you want to make a copy before you use it. So that's it. Basically, you get this stuff to get the mutagen, which is basically liquid, and you mutate it as well. You get the samples out, and with the samples out, these two are just to get some more liquid that we need for this. And these two would be to imprint, and they don't take any mutagen or any liquid over there. So yeah, this is how it goes. As you see, it's not that bad. So these two go into these. This one doesn't take anything. These two are just to create for this. So yeah, we'll find a way to arrange this in a bit. All right, guys, welcome back. So this is what I did. I still have the hole there. I pretty much put the machines here, the mutagen producers, and as you can see, it has hoppers, and the hoppers get filled up with block of redstone, and you know what that goes to. It's just an energy condenser in the back, is just making that. And on the behind this, there is some kinesis pipes, and I've been putting all the pipes in here. So I'm just having a couple of power teleport pipes, and they go to kinesis pipes, and they just power all this stuff. So everything gets like that. So these hoppers, if they point like that, but this thing is full and this thing is full, it will go down. So pretty much just with these configurations and hoppers behind this, like you can see there, they go filling themselves pretty good, and they will keep everything filled up. So yeah, so that's, I put a tank of mutagen here, and then I'll put this basic gate here, and it says here, if there's a space for fluid, then send a pulse. And this thing, obviously, it doesn't have any more space, but I'm thinking it's talking about this one. Anyhow, we can do any other way. If the tank is empty, or if there is fluid in the tank, then go ahead and pulse, and it will try to keep this filled up. And so, obviously, behind this, as you can see right there, there is more diamond kinesis pipes and all this good stuff. Everything here, it's behind the scenes. So, the stuff that is from front, this is the stuff that I want to see moving, like the liquids and all the good stuff. And so this is the first part. Mutagen producers makes this mutagen, and then it puts it into mutatron. And here I can do my mutations of bees. All right, so next thing, I have this set up over here, the genetic sampler. Samples are a very important part of our breakfast because we are gonna need all kinds of samples. And if you can see the recipes here, it's 845 pages. This thing doesn't just sample bees of all kinds and gets all the species. Look at that, species tricky, species tipsy. There's a lot of good stuff here, but it also samples trees and also samples butterflies and all this stuff. So a lot of times you just want to get a bunch of bees and just slap it in there. So I got these distribution pipes, distribution transport pipes, and they're pretty easy to make. You can just do it anyway. And basically it's gonna send to the cyan color, it's gonna send three items, and then it's gonna send one to the greenish, the lime, this one. So it will send three items up, which is for the three over here, and then one here. Obviously, the next one will just send two because there's only two left, and the last one will just send one and one. So it's like a kind of way to distribute your bees and stuff like that. So as soon as you put here bees, they will go and they will pretty much fall into their own places. And these don't get automatically filled up, but anyway, I can just like EMC them and put some more manually. I don't think I'm gonna use that many gene samples in the whole process, but if it does, it does, and I'll just fill it up. Anyhow, so I got these more basic cakes. It says if it's there is active inventory, which they are, but it cannot pull anything out, then pulsate, and it will try to pull that out. And this is our transport pipes, just to stop the fluid to go, the motion of the items inside there to go to the other way. I didn't need this one here, but I just put it there because it looks pretty with the rest. I could have put just a cobblestone like that one. And over here is the rest. So I just lapped there 12 bees. They went to do the thing, and at the end I got this. I got, I think there are 12, right? So there's 3, and there's another 3, and there's another 3, and there's another 3. Yeah, so we got 12 over here. And each of these things got the samples. Now I got the bees, as you can probably see here, right here. All the 12 were wintry bees. So I got species, which is one of the genes things. And then ignores date and nighttime. And then tolerant flyer, there we go. And then speed, that's a different gene. And then flowers, that's a different gene. And effect, that's a different gene. There's effect again, there we go. Temperature, that's a different gene. Ignores day and night, I think that was good here. Ignores day and night, again that. The speed, I think speed was, where is it at? Here. And lifespan. Lifespan was, where is it at? Oh, yeah. So, yeah, we got a cool amount of gene samples, but obviously we didn't have them all. There is a couple of gene samples that we didn't get because obviously there is actually 13 gene samples that we could possibly get. And here, gene. So I'm going to just grab this thing and show you guys how this thing works. I have 3 of this, so I'm just going to waste one here. So all you do is just craft like this, just slap it in there, and it's 1 of 13 chromosomes. So what the hell is that? So you put it that there, and it gives you a blank one, and it will put it in there. So I can just return it right there. So anyhow, so it says, it says 1 of 13 chromosomes, it ignores date and night falls. If you press shift, then you can see the rest of the chromosomes. So there is species, there is ignores day and night, there's flowers, there's speed, there's cave dwelling. That didn't got this one. Effect, lifespan, territory. I didn't think I have territory. Humidity tolerance, I didn't think I have that one. Fertility, I didn't have that one. Flowering, tolerant flyer. So every one of the bees has all these stuff, different qualities or genes. And right now with this one, ignores day and light falls, I can slap it into this guy here, the genetic printer, put it up here, put a bee here, and it will make it force it to ignore day force it not to ignore day and night falls, which means it's not a night ruler. So yeah, this thing is a waste right now. Over here, I have, obviously, if I want to get the copies, I can just put this thing here. And, well, I cannot put it because this thing is there. But if I put it here, I can take this out and put this one here. Or I can put this here, and I can't put that in there. So I can make copies of whatever good genes that I get. And the copies, I will put them in here. So there's 13 possible genes, as we saw in this thing, 13 chromosomes. So there's 3, 6, 9, 12, and the middle one, 13. So I'm going to use the middle one for species, and then I'm going to lay out these ones for the other 13 chromosomes. So I can just have one of a specific one that I can have. So let's say a species. Where is the species? There you go. So I know the middle one was going to be species, so I can just put there my first gene sample. And that's going to be perfect. You see, there is the gene sample. So I'm going to have one of the species, one of the genes for every one of the bees that I'm going to be working on. Next thing, obviously, I think I saw you guys, the imprinter, you put this one here, you put a bee here, and it will force it to pretty much have any chromosomes that you put in there. Next thing, this pork thingy, the protein liquefiers and making protein. And behind the scenes, I have, I don't know if I should open it. As you can see, just what is it gonna call it? The energy condenser, and it's just making pork chop. No big deal. And the pork chop just gets put into here, and it gets being worked out. Under this, as you can see, there is the kinesis pipes, and it's powering these three stuff. So one is the protein liquefier, the other one is a DNA extractor. You just need the fluid. And the DNA extractor would only work with bees or something that has some kind of DNA like that one. I don't know where I collected that one. I think from a village or something. And yeah, you gotta be careful because it will definitely consume it. And it made a little bit and I put it in there, and now I have the DNA there. And now this one I cannot put here because it's not completed. It has to be a full 13 of 13 chromosomes to make your own, what is it called? It will give you a queen. So, yeah, that will give you a queen. All right, so that's pretty much all the stuff for Genestry. But we have one more important one to go. And I was making some some sapphire glass here because I wanted to close up this stuff. I'm kind of nervous. I know the stuff doesn't come in that easy, but anyways, I want to just keep it a little more safe. So I'm going to close that one and close this over here as well. I don't think I'm going to go venturing into some caves or whatever. Just like that. Cool. And there we go. Voila. At least nothing can get in there. And the reason why I was making this stuff is because I wanted to put it right here. And I like this glass better than the other ones. And what is this, you may ask? Well, the next part would be the industrial apiaries. These ones over here. So this stuff over here, it takes obviously it takes power. It takes you can put the bees in there. They can breed as well. You can put the upgrades in here, and they will work with you. So, but anyway, no matter what, it does need some flowers. So what I'm gonna have to do. Well, actually, what I wanted to do is to have a hole up there and to get the sky up there. But I think I'm just going to go ahead and do it here. Don't necessarily need it. But so I'm going to go ahead. I need some sand. I need some soil sand, of course. I need some dirt. And then I'm going to need a lot of like flowers and stuff like that. So I'm just going to go ahead and start building something here. Real quick, bam, bam. Thing like that, maybe like this, maybe like that. I think we need a hole for that one. I'm not even sure. I don't think we need more of that. So that, I don't, do we have grass? Oh, we don't have the actual real grass. Aww. That one will have to come in a little bit later episode then. So let's get this water going on. So check what's going on. So some bees require some kind of different stuff, right? So some bees require like snow, some bees require to be flowers, some others require other stuff. So we're gonna work with all kinds of bees here. So some require nether wart, which I don't have. Wow, that's gonna be an issue right there. Well, we can put what we have. So what we have flowers, I guess. There you go. We got a poppy. There you go. Then we got cactus. That's another flower that some bees require. I think I can put the cactus here. No, I can't put And some require, oh, there you go. Let's put the pop in there. Some require, what else did you require? Oh, lily pad. For the ones that are in the, so I just put the lily pad in there, all good. Some require what, sugarcane? Have no idea, but sounds like it. Put the sugarcane there. Some require vines. So there we go, vines in there. And I don't know what else other flower, other bees require. I'm sure I'm gonna fill up all this stuff with stuff. Some require like snow. So eventually we'll start filling it up. So for now, I'll just leave it like that and just close it up like this. All right, so these would be some of the stuff that some of the bees need. So now here's the tricky part. This thing has a nice top view, but all right, let me figure out how I'm gonna set up this guy, and I'll be right back. All right, welcome back. So here's what I've did. I put this case over here, the industry apiaries. I put obviously power under it, and now we're ready to start production. So I put a couple more items over here. I put the weed in there. I think mushroom wasn't there before, I don't know. And then I put the dragon egg, because the dragon egg would be one of the flowers that some of the bee requires. So I'll just put it in there, just in a pretty place floating kind of thing. Now here's the thing, I have to work with this stuff over here, and I didn't know what to do. Maybe I can put like some signs in here, or but I thought signs would look kind of cheap. I did try it, but I was like, and then I tried to put the sign in top of the chest, and I was like, well, what I'm gonna do around here, I don't know. So what I'm gonna do is I grabbed this computer, and I got my monitor screen editor, and I just decided to put colors on this stuff. So orange and red and yellow and for different stuff, and I'm just gonna put it like all around like this, down here and around here and on the top, and then look at the screen and then look at the over here the wool, and then I can know which one is what, and maybe it kind of makes sense to me. At least I ignore day and night, it's kind of like orangey because, you know, if there's day and night, it's just kind of like dusk. Flowers are red, you know, it's like that, flowers are red and blah blah blah, blue, whatever. Speed, you know, it's like a like flash, you know, like lightning kind of thing, so it kind of yellowish. Cave, the willing, because well, this is if they can't see the sun, so that's kind of grayish. Effect, so the effect will be like purplish, you know, like the ender effect kind of thing. Lifespan, I just left it white because, you know, life is white or whatever. Territory, it will be like a piece of land, so land is brown. And then humidity tolerance, humid, you know, it's kind of like liquid and kind of moist, so I lit it as like light blue. Fertility, pink or magenta because of obvious reasons. Flowering, this will be like how much will the flowers that it's around or whatever, so I don't know, I just thought about it green and kind of grassy. Tolerant flyer, cyan, because it's kind of sky, like a clear sky. And the temperature tolerance, I made it gray because I had no other colors left. So temperature tolerance, I don't know what else can I do. I mean, I can make black or green or a different kind of blue, or I don't know. I would go with orange, but it's not in there, or even red, I don't know. But temperature, I have no idea, maybe like a silver kind of thing. Yeah, like a silver from thermometers or something like that, maybe, I don't know. So my next thing is I'm trying to get the wool out of here, right? And it turns out that I just have white, purple, black, brown, and gray, which are basic stuff, so I have to get the rest of the wool. And one easy way to do this is just lay out your wool like this, just like that. I don't think I need the mold though. And then just grab your philosopher's stone and bam, smack that thing. And if you mistake, let's say I went one more and I need to go back, so you just shift and click and I'll go to the back one. Now obviously when you're halfway, it's easier actually to make it backwards. It's like this, if you know where to end. So like that, red and black. Yeah, that's it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yeah, 16 colors. That's all we need to do. So just grab this stuff from here. And then one by one on the, obviously, on the transmutation tablet, I'll just put it in here, put it out, and just like that. I think something like this would work. Yeah, there we go. So I got my pace down. So something like that. It will keep learning them. Just like this, just like this, just like that, just like that. And by now I should have all the colors learned, I believe. So if I type wool, there we go. We got pretty much all the colors. Yeah, 3 plus, there's 3, 6, 9, 12. Yeah, there you go. 12 plus 3, that's 15 though. I don't know. I think I'm missing orange, no? Am I missing the orange one? No, the orange one's on this side. So it's white, orange. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. There you go, so 16. Boom. All right, so now we can start putting the wool wherever we need it. Cyan. We may not have learned cyan. There we go. Now we're complete. All right, so ignores day and night. That'll be the orange. I'm gonna go ahead and start like here, you know, like clockwise. I could have started on the right side, but I'm gonna start with here. There we go. That will be ignores day and night. Then we need the red for the flowers. Right there. And then yellow for speed. Right there. How's that? Yeah, it doesn't look that bad. Cave dueling, that would be the gray. Actually, I should get a couple. So gray, purple, white. Okay, I'll do that. Gray, purple, and then white. Why not? So just like that. Gray, purple, white. The white didn't work out so well, did it? All right, it's fine. And then here should be backwards. So brown, light blue, and pink. There we go. Brown, light blue, and pink, or magenta. Brown, light blue, and magenta. There we go. Because I think that's magenta, isn't it? Yeah, pink is a little more clear. That one's magenta. Anyhow, so lime, cyan, and gray. That will be the top one right there. So that will be lime, cyan, and light gray. And backwards like this. Lime, cyan, and dark gray. Something like that, no? And obviously the middle one, we don't need anything because we know that the middle one is just the actual species. So that should be fine then. All right, so next thing is I'll pick up a place to put this computer there. For now, I'm just going to leave it in there. It's fine. I think I should just actually save this thing. So save as a list. There we go. So it's going to save a file, and then I can pull it out some other day. It's a 2x2 computer monitor, and then that will let me know. So as soon as I see this, like let's see, the temperature tolerance is up by one. So temperature tolerance, that will be the gray, so that will be up here, up here, up here. Of course you cannot open the chest, it has a block top on the top, right? So okay. All right, so anyways, that would be up here, right? So there we go. And that will be gray, which is temperature tolerance. The middle one is cyan, and this is lime. There we go. Something like that. Yeah, I think so. I could put it right behind the chest, though, but then the whatever is inside is going to look weird. I don't know. I'll figure it out later. Anyhow, so next thing, life farm short. So lifespan. Lifespan would be a white one right here. And the next one would be day and night. That would be easy. That would be the orange one. And this one, I don't care. Then tolerant flyer. So that would be the cyan, right? I don't even need to see it anymore. There you go. I mean, if it makes logic for you, then you shouldn't have any problems. So this one, I don't care. So that would be the speed. So it's the yellow. I don't even need to see it anymore. There you go, yellow speed. You see, if it makes sense for you, if it has a meaning for you, then we should be all fine. So let's see, flowers, no. So flowers are red, so that will be the second one. And then this one, both are freezing. So it's the effect, that will be the purple one, if I'm not sure. There you go, effect, purple. There you go, so that's it. So we are missing a couple of the stuff in here, like fertility, this is a very important one, and other stuff like that. So I think that's it. I probably don't need this permanently. I can leave it there, but for now, I think I can figure it out which one is which one. Like this is a territory, and this is tolerant flyer. This is tolerant flyer, and this is what is that one? Humidity. Okay. Yeah, I think I can get used to it. It's fine. All right. So next step is to start working on this stuff over here. So I'm gonna grab a lot of the bees that I have on there. And even if you have, even if you have like repeated samples, I'm just gonna grab like a stack is fine. I don't think I need a stack, but I'll deal with this stuff. So, we're getting more with this stuff. Look at this, we're still getting some more out here. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm just gonna take all this stuff out here and just get all the bees that we can. The next thing we need to do is obviously craft a list of the things that we need to go to get to the point where we need to be, right? So I'm just gonna slap those ones out there, and immediately this basic gate will start immediately pulling it out, as you can see. And it will send three up and one inside, three up and one inside. So that's how it is. It will be very balanced, so you don't have to like worry that all the bees are here and it's doing one by one. It will be doing a couple by a couple. And obviously on this side also, they will start falling out. Now these things, I need to take care of it because these are pretty much wasted ones that I don't need, effect freezing and stuff like that. So eventually they will start falling in here. And fertility four, that fertility, that's the one that I really wanted. So I'm going to go for putting it up here because that would give me a lot of bees. And as you remember, these winter drones, they give me a lot of stuff. Territory, that's a good one. Cave dueling, that's a good one. Although, this is for territory, and cave dueling was this dark gray. Although territory is just average, and cave dueling is nothing, so... tolerant fire, I think we did one already. Fertility again. Lifespan, short. We did that already with the white one. Ignores night and day, that's already done. Species, already done. Lifespan, short. Temperature tolerance, I'm not sure about this one. Did we do temperature tolerance? Yeah, we did. So I think we have pretty much one of each, right? So there we go, there we go, there we go. We're missing this green one, which is flowering. And we're missing this humidity tolerance. Okay, so let's see. Temperature, there we go. No. Flowering, there we go. And yeah, it seems like we are not getting it yet. But we definitely don't like need it, so I can just leave it there. Now, obviously, this stuff doesn't have EMC, so you're saying, what am I going to do with this? Well, there's an easy thing to do with this. You can cook it, and if you cook it, you basically get it a blank again. Or, well, it's melting, of course. Or you can put it into a squeezer. There we go. So you put it into a squeezer, and what do you think you can get? You can get liquid DNA out of it. Obviously, you probably are better getting DNA out of the actual bees, maybe. But I don't mind. I mean, it's just a lot of liquid DNA in here. And as soon as you put something here, it will immediately fall in here. And this is the only reason why you would need liquid DNA. So just to use it on the generic replicator, there's nothing else that you can do with liquid DNA. So yeah, that will be fine. We grab this and we need to make a squeezer next time. Next thing we need to make a squeezer, and next thing we need to make a list of the bees that we need to start breeding. So I think I'm gonna leave it here. I don't know, you guys tell me what do you think of this setup. If I can do something better, let me know. And if you like it, well, let me know as well. I'll be really happy to hear your comments and everything. So I'm gonna start working on the list to have on the programmed list. This should be like a step one, step two, step three kind of thing. And then I'm gonna start another episode later on with this bee stuff and this bee laboratory. So this is Angel Malus, Steve right now. Thank you for watching. See you guys. Bye bye.